I've made a copy of database ODB57 and I made some changes to it. I'm calling this one ODB58B4. Then I made a copy of that and I'm calling the one we're working on ODB58 Cleanup and Review. So if you want to work along with me, you might want to download ODB58B4 from my website. The changes I made were, in the tables, I removed the employee's original table. In the queries, I removed all of the queries. And in the forms, I removed everything except ODB48 Employee Edit Form and ODB57 Employee Search Form Part 2. The idea behind this video is to summarize everything we've learned so far into three forms: an Add Employee Form, an Edit Employee Form, and a Search for Employee Form. Let's start by adding the new employee. I'm going to make a copy of ODB48 Employee Edit Form by right-clicking, Copy, then right-clicking, Paste, and we'll call this one Add New Employee. I'm going to right-click and edit. The first thing I want to do is update this label. So I'm clicking on that to select it, right-clicking and opening up the control. Add New Employee. I'm going to click on this control that we no longer need and delete that. Now I want to bring up the Form Navigator. I'm going to right-click on the main form, go into Properties. Under the Data tab, we want to allow additions but not allow modifications, changing that to no, and not allow deletions, changing that one to no. Same thing for our subform. Allow additions, no to allow modifications, and no to allow deletions. Let's save this and see how it looks. I'm going to go into design mode. We see that it brings up the first record that it finds and places it on the form. Because it's sorting by employee ID, it's bringing up employee record number 3. What I'm going to do is close this, going into our employee table under tables, double clicking to open up the employee table. I'm going to add a new employee, going to give him the last name of required, first name of required, and then under the department ID, I'm going to make that 0 and group ID 0. Clicking on the next record assigns an employee ID, and I don't want that to be 30. I'm going to change that to 0. Now this will be the lowest record and the one that shows up on our Add Employee form. Let's save this, close it. Going back into Forms, I'm going to right click on our Add New Employee and edit that. Now what I want to do is add a couple of buttons. Add one here and another one right next to it. I'm going to right-click and open up the control for this one. I'm going to rename this label to say New Record. Then down at the bottom, I want to change this action to New Record. The other button, I'm going to change this to say Save Record. And change our action to Save Record. Now I want to select them both, and I'm going to change the font from black to red, and I want to make this bold 12. I also want to change the width to be 1.5 and the height to be 0.5. That looks pretty good. I also want to set a default value for the group name and the department name. So I'm going to hold down Control, click on the group name text box, add Shift as well as Control, click on the department name text box, and down at the bottom where they have default selection, I'm going to put in 0. This should be good. Let's save it and try it out in design mode. When I open the form, it will show me this first record where the last name's required, first name's required, and we want to click on the new record to add a new record. I will type in the name, Bill Smith. Now we can enter a new record or save the record. If I click New Record, this will save the current record and prepare the form for a new record. If I click Save the Record, it will just save the current record. It looks like it worked. Let's save the form, close this, and check our table, make sure it was updated properly. Down at the bottom, we see Bill Smith. Going back to our forms, we want to update our other two forms as well, and we'll do that in the next video.